Still wrestling with the onslaught by dengue and chikungunya, the island registered its first case of malaria last month when an Indian student arrived here exhibiting symptoms of the disease. Subsequent lab tests confirm that the disease and the victim was attended to immediately. All reports are that he is doing well. So far, his appears to be an isolated case.
For the last 5 years, for example, we have recorded one or two cases of imported malaria by visitors, and we have not recorded any local transmission on the island.
Regardless, the ministry says it is leaving nothing to chance and has activated its ports screening program and has active surveillance teams at all ports of entry.
We have nurses who are screening passengers as they come in. And they have them under surveillance for any disease whatsoever, because we recognize that we must have systems in place to pick up diseases of every nature, primarily infectious diseases.
Health officials have begun meeting with airlines and circulating questionnaires for completion by all arriving passengers requesting and providing basic health information. The ministry is also preparing for the start of the cruise season and is putting systems in place for any outbreaks on visiting vessels. The St. Lucia Air and Seaports Authority has also provided a refurbished quarantine room at the Hirundura International Airport should the need for such a facility arise. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Bousquet.